sometimes you're like, you're told the whole time, you're working, communicating, trust, but things happen and they wait till you get there to tell you. And you're in a whole different city than you. Okay. You know, there's nothing I can do about it at this point. So of course, God still, because he placed in the function and following through, somehow he takes even the things that are just off and he causes by his grace and glory me to do it well. And I'm even surprised. I'm like, how did you do that? Because I was mad. Or I was wearing the same stinky clothes. How did you do that? You know what I'm saying? So it's the real world. It doesn't change in my world, your world.
Yeah.
You know, you get the local body, as a mother church, you get to church, you're like, why didn't they come? Like, my goodness, not his. What? You know, you're just walking in, hardly any chairs, you're just thinking, I pray, study, I gotta get up. Didn't even come. Am I being too honest and open?
No.
No.
Oh, okay.
Probably for Facebook, but hopefully not for you. It's true. And I'm thinking, you know, I come to my seat and think, God, I don't know if I can do this today. And then these people that have this special function up here start leading us, and he just comes.
Amen.
Because we intentionally are a body that chooses
Amen.
To allow the presence of the Lord to come, and we are going to worship through him. We are going to wait on him.
Amen.
And then as he comes, it's like chairs are all full. And everybody that need to be here is here.
Amen.
And I leave feeling like $1,000,000 because all of that other really didn't matter. It mattered to my flesh at the time, but it didn't make God nervous or any less passionate about what he wanted to say and do and accomplish. I'm like, wow, how did you do that? Because I was a real knothead right at service time. Focused on the wrong things. But still follow through.
Yeah. Right.
And so I did it. Through, by him, through him, but follow through, did it. So he calls, do it well. Same with you. So I'm that transparent and open in saying more times than not, you're not going to feel like it. You're not going to feel it.
Right.
I don't feel it today. I don't feel like it. I don't feel it serving.
Right.
I don't feel it my function. No. That's when you keep following.
That's right.
And follow through even though you're not feeling it.
Amen.
Which is good practical preaching.
Amen. Good stuff.
Okay, second closing almost. Says you're going to do it well, so serving others. So he says, God has given us different gifts for doing certain things well. So does God, who has given the ability to prophesy. Speak out with as much faith as God has given you. So somebody gives the gift to prophesy. And so you speak out, even though you're nervous, and follow through with what he's given you in faith. And you're going to be nervous. And by the way, and I meant to come back to it as a teaching point, And it's very likely, because many who are here Sunday are not here tonight, so it may not be anybody that's here tonight, but as I was just praying and studying these verses, it came back to my mind. As soon as the message came for Sunday morning, the Lord put the interpretation in my heart, but he also immediately put in my heart, Ronnie, I want you to hold it because I want to use someone else. Mm-hmm. And so I spoke that out and waited and gave what I felt like was ample time, and then went on and I gave the interpretation. And so I just mentioned that to say that if that was you, I just want to encourage you. God will use your personality, your gift, your vocabulary, the way you're made up, but it will still be, in essence, the same message. The same message will come forward. But he doesn't make us robots as that's coming. And so if he wants to use you in the gift of interpretation, which tongues and interpretation of tongues basically together does the same thing as prophecy in the body.
Amen.
So sometimes he will only give you maybe three or four words. Maybe a sentence. And you step out in faith with that, and as you do, it becomes like a river just flowing out.
Amen.
That's what I found to be true. But I found the first few words are the hardest to get out. Mm-hmm. And I've also found that you grow in that function, mm-hmm. as in every other.